Good morning, viewers. Today, I am present before you with the very famous poem of Philip Larkin, Church Going. Before I begin the podcast, it is advisable that you keep a notebook and a pen so that you can jot down the important points relating to this particular poem. It is further advisable that you use earplugs while listening to the podcast. So here I begin. The speaker says that he goes into a church building after making sure that no ceremony or ritual is being performed at the time. Inside the building of the church, he sees the matting on the floor, the seats, and a number of Bibles. He also sees flowers which had been placed inside on Sunday last and which have now faded somewhat. He sees the small organ or the piano-like instrument which produces the music to which the choir sings during the worship. The speaker in the poem is not wearing any hat, and therefore he takes off his bicycle clips to show his reverence. The speaker moves forward in the church and runs his hand around the font receptacle for holy water close to which he now stands. The roof of the church building looks almost new, as if it had been cleaned or renovated. Then he mounts the lectern and goes through a few verses in a Bible. At the end of his reading, he loudly says that the verses have been perused by him. In reply to his loud utterance of these words, he hears an echo of those words as if somebody were mocking at him. Then he goes back to the entrance of the church, signs the book kept there for the purpose, drops an Irish sixpence into the charity box and comes out. It seems to him that it was not worthwhile for him to stop on his way in order to go inside and spend a little time there. It now occurs to the speaker that he had often stopped outside a church building and then gone inside. But every time he had gone into a church, he had afterwards felt that he had merely wasted his time. He had always wondered on these occasions why he had gone inside the church and what he had been looking for. He had also asked himself what purpose the church buildings would serve when people stopped going to churches altogether. Perhaps a few of the churches would be converted into museums where such articles as the parchment, the plate, and the pics would be placed in locked cases for the visitors to see. The remaining church buildings would perhaps be offered free of rent to rain and to sleep. There is also the possibility that people would begin to avoid these church buildings as unlucky places. But there is another possibility too. Stray, unknown women might visit the deserted and desolate churches and make their sick children touch particular stones so that the children might get well. Some of these women might seek the cure of their children from cancer by making them touch some holy object or some holy spot there. Some of the women might even hope to see the spirits of their dead relatives walking about in those deserted buildings. Some sort of supernatural power would still be perceived by these women in those forsaken buildings. Of course, all such women would come to an end just as religious belief had previously come to an end and rendered these churches useless. What would happen after superstition or disbelief has also ended? Asks the speaker. In course of time, only grass, weeds, thorny plants and shrubs would be seen on the ground inside the decayed buildings and outside the buildings as well. With the passing of each week, these church buildings would become less and less recognizable so that the people passing the ruins of these buildings would not know what purpose these buildings had served. The speaker in the poem then wonders who would be the last person, the very last person to visit a church for its religious and spiritual significance would be some genuine worshipper or some antiquarian or some fellow who had been in the habit of visiting a church at Christmas and who now wanted to recall the original atmosphere of a church. Or the last person to visit a church would be a man like the speaker himself in this poem. The last person to visit this church might resemble the speaker too. He might be a person who is feeling bored with everything in life, an ignorant person, a person seeking some knowledge about the ceremonies which used to be held here, ceremonies that were held on the occasions of a marriage or a birth or a death. In any case, the speaker in the poem feels pleased to stand silently inside a church even though he has no idea of the worth of the church, which is well equipped but which to him is no better than a darn. Finally, the speaker in the poem feels that a church is a serious house situated on a serious earth and that in its air are mingled all those human urges which bring people to it. People look upon a church as a place which decides their respective destinies. This feeling of the people can never become obsolete. In other words, the spiritual essence of the churches would never be completely ignored and forgotten. Someone or the other will at all times experience a desire to visit a church, even a ruined church, because some people in every age would remember having heard that a church was a place where one could become wise. These people would think that a visit to a church could make a man wise, if for no other reason then because of the simple fact that numerous dead persons lay buried in the churchyard. So this was all about the poem Church Going. Please mention your questions and observations in the comment section below. Please do like, share and subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. Thank you for your valuable time. Here's wishing everyone a great day ahead.